This is Sway.
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 In the morning.
In the morning.
In the morning.
I'm shaking this vibe.
Wake your fuck ass up.
Give it up for Chris and Gray, you guys. Before you go, I have to ask you a question, because you actually inspire people through your words. How difficult was that, and how were you able to accomplish that?
I think it was hard until I started to think about the music I grew up listening to from Detroit. I'm a big Marvin Winans fan, you know, and I came up, still do listen to the Motown era. So, like, I'm home from the standpoint of good heritage and good music. And once you got greats before you like that, legends like that, it becomes easy to really respect the art form enough to be authentic and true to yourself. And man, honestly, man, I just got a story that only God could tell. So I might as well tell what he gave me to say.
That's Christian Gray, ladies and gentlemen. MC, singer, elevationist.
Me gusta.
If you will.
What?
That's where it all started and began.
Wow.
His career.
Threw me off with that one.
I will say, man, I dig. I really enjoy this guy. We just actually had an event on the east side of Detroit with Joel Osteen.
Yeah.
And I invited.
Mile.
Yeah, right. And I invited a few friends that I thought through their music, through their ways and actions, set a fine example for a lot of youth to look at, especially those who are entering this music business and think you only have a couple of options.
Yeah.
One being, I got to make party rap and talk about drugs. The other being, I got to make party rap and talk about violence. And that's kind of what a lot of folks do.
Yeah.
You got those standouts like a Kendrick, you know, or a J. Cole.
Yeah.
That speak to the people and I think try to give them nourishment. And this is no judgment on how folks create.
Right.
But what appeals to me is artists who make me feel great after I listen to their music, make me feel like I learned, make me feel inspired. And it could come from different ways. I felt inspired by Get Rich and Die Trying when 50 made that album. Yeah. I was like, yo, man, I'm about to get out here, translate that into my hustle. You know, and Christian Gray has done that continuously throughout his career. If you don't know him, get to know him. He's here with us today. He has the Glory album out right now. The one and only Christian Gray.
Yo, thank you, man.
Gray.
Yeah, man.
It means a lot to be here. I mean, I'm inspired by every Jay-Z record I hear, too. Like, I'm not even really from the streets like that. But it was the authenticity that you hear in music that now, like, you know, it's kind of back and forth. I mean, I'm not really sure what these guys' stories are now. And it's, like you said, it's no judgment. It's just trying to do something that's authentic to my story, and hopefully it touches some people. And if it doesn't, like if they're not from my world, then, you know, maybe they want to be.
Yeah, and maybe they'll look into it.
Yeah.
You know, but it doesn't mean they have to ignore it. And you talk about your story. Tell us your story. Were you born in?
Yeah, I was born in Columbus, Ohio. Mm-hmm. Yep, born and raised. Buckeye State. I mean, you know, Ohio got a lot of heritage going on. When you say that, the first thing they think about is Bron and them. You know what I'm saying?
Who?
LeBron James.
Who does he play for? He's from Oakland.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Well, you know, it was a great series, man. I mean, we needed this. Was 52 years. Look, you know, it was hard, you know?
Listen, man, I'm a big fan of Kyrie. I'm a huge fan of LeBron. I love LeBron. Whatever team he plays on, I'm going to love him. Until he plays on. It's the goal.
I'll tell you what, he's not coming to Oakland. You know,
Kevin Durant, y'all a little stacked there now. Yeah,
yeah.
So we'll match those two up, and hopefully y'all won't get Draymond kicked out of a game, and we can have a real series. We ain't worried, man.
Okay. Just let's go to the game together, man.
Okay,
let's go to one. We'll sit next to each other.
Let's do it in Cleveland. All right.
we'll sit next to each other, man.
Christian Gray is here. So what was your life like growing up as a child?
I mean, I grew up in church. You know, Christian household. My parents been together for, I say, upward of 35 years now.
Nice.
And, you know, I got an older brother, a little sister. My brother's a pastor. My father's a pastor. My little sister's in education. And I was like the weird artistic, you know, designer slash musician. I taught myself how to play piano at age 11, a singer. You know, you sing in the shower off key, you hear about it through the whole house. Everybody, like, you know, get the notes straight. You know what I mean? Like, it was that sort of vibe. And, yeah, man, I mean,
I think the further I got into the music scene, the more I realized that this was not just like a hobby for me, like it was a dream. I had something that I was trying to tell myself through music. Mm-hmm. And so it caused me to keep creating. And then I started to look up and I was telling other people's stories too. Mm-hmm. So, you know, now at age 30, you know, I got a little 4-year-old daughter. Everybody's still in Columbus. I've been married for 7 years. That's been rough recently. You know what I mean? The past 4 years has been very difficult.
Why is that?
You know, I think that this game is really intense. And so every album I've put out since 2011, that was my first independent release. My life is an equation, so you can see exactly what I'm going through in my music. And so when you start off independently, things look great. You got high dreams. And then when you sign to majors or even independent labels, like, you introduce yourself to a larger audience of people, and then that affects you. The game affects you. It affects your family. It affects your lifestyle. And I think that, you know, when you're in a committed relationship, whether it's a marriage or whether it's just, you know, boyfriend and girlfriend, whatever, like, you find yourself having to answer the question, how much of this am I able to do? Where there's not a lot of people who can understand what you actually go through. And it's a choice every day. And sometimes that stuff is rocky, man.
Are there Christian groupies?
Oh yeah, all day. I'm
Christian groupies?
Especially as a singer. I've gotten this, like, you know, I go out and sing. I had a record on an album that charted really well with my last crew. Mm-hmm. And I had a song in there called Long Way Down. And the whole song, I'm literally like singing to Satan as if we were in a relationship. And I mean, the girls, like, they're screaming. Mm-hmm. You know, and I'm like, you get to a point where you're like, you're surprised by it, but you're not. Because, I mean, just because we're Christians, that doesn't mean we don't go through everyday life. Nothing's really different. It's just that we're trying to live for something greater than ourselves. And so, yeah, there's Christian groupies and there's non-Christian groupies. I mean, it is what it is. I mean, sometimes I've been a groupie.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, you know, some of the
like
stuff.
Like with Kirk Franklin, you work with Kirk, right?
Yeah, I work with Kirk. Kirk is the man, and Kirk is one of the realest out there. You know what I mean? We talk about real life all the time. I mean, sometimes it's not even always, are they hanging on my shoulder? Sometimes it's been me, you know, being foolish. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I mean,
luring them to you.
Yeah, or just
indirectly.
Yeah, right. Yeah. I mean, you go through it. You know, when you're on the road, it's real life. Like, I'm not one who's gonna try to paint some picture of myself like I'm better or that I don't struggle, but in all of it, like, the message remains the same. And I think what we're trying to talk about and how much Jesus we actually talk in our message, you need to see these real life experiences to make that real. Otherwise, you look lofty and you look like you're somewhere that other people can't get and that you're perfect. Mm-hmm. I'm like, nah, man. Like, I'm just glad y'all don't see me, you know, every hour of every day and all of my mess ups and all of my mistakes, and that I'm fighting to keep being better. And Kirk has been the perfect example of that as
Kirk
well.
Kirk Franklin, and he had his, he's faced a lot of adversity, and he's had challenges in his marriage and his personal life as well that have all been made public. And he came on this show and on this show and answered a lot of hard questions.
Absolutely.
Even about sexuality and things, you know. And so just because you're a rapper who has a Christian faith doesn't mean you're exempt from Christian groupie head.
Mm. Yeah, I mean, being
right.
Yeah, I mean, you know,
Christian groupie head.
We as Christian groupie head. That's a long. That's a long hashtag.
Christian girl gives better heads than regular girls. Way.
What?
I ask you.
Yeah,
Catholic school girls.
Is this thing?
I mean,
Tracy
they've been
went to Catholic
back.
School, and so did I. Yeah, you've been held back. It's the uniform. It's
that's the whole thing, though, right?
Yeah.
Like, you grow up in church and you're trying to
suppress. Yeah, my bad. Not oppressed.
Oppressed. You know, some of the stuff we was learning wasn't all the way right. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, like, you know, and then some of it was, and we felt oppressed because we just couldn't live up to it. I mean, there was only one who could.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, that's half the battle. Is like, I'm not Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So when you look at me, I'm trying to point you to him, but I ain't him.
Right.
So they like, well, you know, I'm like, nah, I got problems. You probably want to stay away. It's wild out there.
How long were you with your wife before you guys got married?
A couple years. I met her. My brother introduced me to her at a party with a girl that he was trying to get away from, and he brought me out there so I could be the class clown, the party clown. And I ended up in there, and she was sitting in some room, and I sat next to her. She gave me the little side eye, and I was just like, man, she's really interesting. Like, she was Apple at the top of the tree. You know, she wasn't hanging low. You know what I'm saying? So I really saw that something to aspire to. But as soon as I talked to her, I was on it. I was like, let's go. I was only 19.
Oh, wow.
So we got married at 22. I was 22. So a couple, few years. We was off and on. Some of that was like me just jacking up. I had a bunch of doors I had to close. I ain't close them right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Then came back.
Other women.
Mm-hmm. I brought in a long relationship, you know, the burden of that into my marriage. And that was hard working through that because I still felt guilty for how we ended. And, you know, it just gets sloppy. But I knew going into this game that I needed something stable ahead of time so that I could have some validity to my message and too, so I just wouldn't go wild.
Wow.
So I was trying, you know.
That's real.
And still am. But we dropped the remix to my record Stop Me Today, and the whole first verse you hear me talk exactly where we at.
Okay, this is Christian Gray. We're going to listen to that now.
Yeah,
right? I want to see what y'all think, man.
Okay, absolutely. And just to give you some history on him. This guy was chosen as one of ESPN's Artists of the Month.
ESPN, the sports network?
Yeah. Okay. He's had...
shout out to Darren Haynes and Chris Broussard.
He had a track, King and Me, which was used as a theme song to America Idol Super Bowl.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. His Apple Music selected Open Door, See You Later, and Fort Knox, that's featured on his album, as Best of the Week singles back-to-back.
Dope.
His... you know, the Glory Part One to Stop Me, all of the, you know, in Open Door are highlighted tracks.
Yeah.
That he has a track that's been used in commercials for Honda, HBO Ballers, and Rock Nation Sports. Mm. I mean, this is Christian Gray is somebody who's doing as well, if not better than most of the rappers you hear in mainstream genre. Yeah. He's selling albums. The content in his music sticks to your ribs.
Right.
You can listen to his music with your kids and your grandparents all at once, and he's no sucker when it comes to being an MC. Mm-hmm. When we did our event with Joel Osteen, he said, Sway, I want to do the Five Fingers of Death.
Oh, wow.
I got mad at him. Like, I hate when people come up to me and do that, and then you come up on the show and it doesn't work.
Right.
Yeah.
So what I want to do is open up the phone lines. Christian Gray, you can find him on social media at
Christian Gray, CHRISTONGRAY. I get a lot of that Christian Gray sometimes. That's
Christian.
Shades,
yeah,
I'm like,
Christian Gray.
Get it right.
Okay, the Glory album. I've been killing your name.
It's good, man.
All right.
I'm on Sway.
Hey, man. You know, take a few lumps.
Yeah.
You know, next to that Christian girl head.
Yeah.
Wow, yo.
We're going to come back, let them do the Five Fingers of Death, and then have them do some performance songs. But citizens, even if you don't know, I want you to call and talk to this man. 888-742-3345. This is the remix to Stop Me on his album, the Glory album. And it's out for the first time.
Yep, right now.
Right now. We're the first to play it. Sway in the Morning, Shade 45. Morning, Shade 45. That's the Stop Me remix. You got it first right here on Sirius XM. Christian Gray is here. The Glory album is out. We got Tyler from South Carolina on the line. Tyler, what up?
Tyler, what up? What's up, man? Yo, I just want to say I appreciate you, Sway, for bringing me all this this good new music. Man, I love this song, though. This track is hot.
Thank you, man. It is so fucking fire. Thank you, homie.
It's powerful, right, Tyler? You get rejuvenated. Like, I feel like this is what I want to play in the shower before I come to work.
Exactly. Yeah. You know what? There's so much stupid shit going on in the radios these days, and I'm sick of it. Yeah. I love this track. I love hearing it. I want to hear more. I want to hear more and more and more.
Okay. Yo, thanks, homie.
Hey, man, pick up his album, Christian Gray. It's called the Glory Album. It's more songs on it. And the dude is versatile. Okay, we got from the Bronx, we got BX from the Bronx. BX!
What's going on?
What's up, man? What you want to say to Christian Gray?
Yo, man, I love your work. Your story was inspiring with your wife. And just like, you know, it's very uplifting, you know, to see cats like, you know, doing their thing and being respectful about it and just trying to stay stable. It helps us, the rest of us, you know, with our situations, stay stable as well, you know, and mm-hmm. just grind and want to make it, you know.
Keep going, man. Thank you, bro.
That's the purpose for you, though, right? For your music to kind of...
Yeah, I mean, you know, there's some darkness that you see me really explore, and everything's not resolved either, you know what I'm saying? But at the same time, like, people need to hear that. They need an outlet. So I'm hoping that continues to encourage you. Stay blessed, bro.
Yeah, well, people need to know it's real. Yeah. It's not an imaginary thing. I think when we hear marriage sometimes, we just think of the fantasy. We think of the weddings and the dresses and the cakes and the gifts. It's a real...
This is real shit.
It's real shit.
What about weed or alcohol? How do you indulge at all? You've been tempted to smoke some blueberry kush?
Ooh.
You know, I here's the other thing about me. I grew up, I'm just awkward. Like, I never really wanted to. But it wasn't like, yo, that's bad. I just didn't want to. So recently, like, I just turned 30.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I've tried to see how I hold my liquor. I've tried to, you know, smoke and just, it's whatever. Like, I've never looked at that as like, oh, that's a terrible thing. I'm just not that type of guy now. Mm-hmm. Like, I think I got drunk for the first time, at the BET Awards, at Miguel's after party. I got introduced to a French Connection. And I hadn't eaten anything all day.
That's not the way to start.
But the thing about it was I wasn't wild. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, I do have a standard I'm trying to uphold. So, mm-hmm. like, it's good to even see myself when I've gone too far in any area to know that I'm protected, that I got people around me. And, to answer your question, I'll try to drink a little bit here and now and then. Yeah. And some of that stuff is therapeutic. I mean, I wouldn't be telling anybody to drink or smoke just because I can get wild. But, yeah.
Okay.
That's what it is.
Christian Gray is here, the Glory album. Nareen is on the line from Virginia. Go ahead, Nareen.
Hello. I just wanted to first say hi.
Good morning.
I had never listened to your music before. However, I do love, you know, all the others, you know, in the St. Phil, Lecrae, Tribly, D1, all that. But I want to also say thank you, Sway, for bringing all types of artists onto your show, because a lot of times this is the first time that I'm hearing this music. So I do want to say hi, thank you, congratulations. And then also it's refreshing to hear someone just be honest about, you know, the ups and downs with marriage and life, you know, but still trying to walk the straight and narrow. So thank you.
Thank you for listening.
You got a song called Blackmail on your album. And it gets into that too a little bit, right?
Yeah.
Like, Black, talk about that song.
So there's a lot of racial injustice going on. I mean, that's not a new topic.
Mm-hmm.
We just got hit with it in Columbus, and I just heard about the event in Tulsa. And that stuff's painful as a black man.
Yeah.
And it's really hard. So I knew I needed to address it, but I didn't want to address it with any hostility. So I wrote a story, me and my man Shabby, where Shabby's from Toronto in Canada. They're not really dealing with the same type of racial injustice as we are,
mm-hmm.
As it's not as embedded as it is here.
Mm-hmm.
So we wrote this love story about a black man and a white woman trying to find a way to love each other in the midst of all of this racial injustice.
Mm.
I think the future of society looks a lot more... you know, it's much more of a melting pot than we've even experienced in our generation and the one before us. And you see us talk about those different situations and how, you know, what the black man goes through can't fully be understood by the white woman, but how they're coming together to love. I featured a good friend of mine, Lauren Heatherly. She's a white woman, and she was on the bridge of the song, just mm-hmm. kind of showing the struggle. Because at the end of the day, if we're not trying to approach love in all of this, we're going to end up killing each other. And there is no solution if we're always focused on what we're owed or what we think we're owed, because all of us have fallen short in so many areas. At this point, it's just how to move forward.
Mm-hmm.
And so I figured the best way to tell that was to tell it through a love story.
Yeah. All right. Kristen Gray is here. It's a great album. We got a lot more callers, but one of the things you said to me is, we just talked about some of the artists that are out, and you know, right now this is a big mumble rap movement. I got Alcifa from Texas on the line, and good morning. How you doing, Alcifa?
Salam. Doing good, Mr. Sway.
What comment you wanted to make?
The comment I want to make and the question I have is that I really like this gentleman, that song, and being that, you know, there's a lot of that mumble rap crap that I just can't feel. There's no art, you know, there's no art or style into it. And I just want to, I really like it. I just want to know what this young gentleman, could he tell everyone out here, how does he keep going and doing what he does, even though you're up against like this mumble rap, like Designer and everything? Because to me, it's disheartening, and I just want to, like, sometimes quit. So if he can say something,
he's stressed.
Maybe one day I can be on the Sway Show and somebody interviews me. I mean, it's really positive.
Okay, hold on the line. Let's let him answer that.
Go ahead. You know, I'm still a student in the game. I'm listening to what's out, and I'm not so quick to just say, you know, that it may not be my preference, but I'm not so quick to say that it's all trash. I came up in a different era. I came up listening to Mos Def, Common, Jay-Z, Nas, you know, Stevie Wonder. So it's just I have a different expression. The way I keep trying to remain steady is knowing that, one, you know, the reason I do this is to just represent Jesus, and I want people to hear clarity in my lyrics. So I have a duty to give you that. And then artistically, that expression just keeps coming out. So I'm glad that you're inspired by it, bro. And, you know, I hope to give you more.
All right. Hey, so
no broads in Atlanta.
No, okay. No broads in Atlanta?
Nah.
You ain't got no broads in Atlanta?
Nah. I do like that record, though.
That's a banging ass song. Get out of here, man.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I can't just be like, yo, like, I don't like all of it. It's just, I'm learning from it.
Yeah.
You know?
Do they have people who use that style in Christian rap that you know of that got more of a mumble type style,
as they call it,
Christian trap.
Besides the gentleman y'all heard featured on that Stop Me remix, my homie Jay Givens, who's out in L.A. Like, I'm kind of out of the game. I still keep in touch with some of them dudes, but
you just making music.
Yeah, man. Like, I can't tell you the latest single in Christian hip hop.
Doing you,
the Glory album.
I'm not sure what we're doing.
Yeah, so we'll. You stepped off the pulpit into the valley of the hyenas, young man.
Hyenas.
There ain't no protection in that valley.
I know.
You on your own.
I know.
God is patting you on the back and say, step on up, son.
Risk factor.
Okay.
Rumble, young man.
Welcome,
be with me, Lord. Y'all might hear me mumble.
Kristen Gray is here, ladies and gentlemen, and it's time for the one and only Five Fingers of Death.
You are now entering the Five Fingers of Death.
DJ Wonder plays five unique beats meant to test your lyrical stamina.
I saw the look in his eyes. This guy is crazy.
Many have tried.
I'm the best. This is just another chance for me to prove it.
But many have failed.
Give me some hip-hop.
It's the Five Fingers of Death.
Kristen Gray, you know the rules, baby. You told me you wanted to do this. You came up to me. That's one of the first things you said. Five beats by DJ Wonder, designed to trip you up and throw you off your square. Beat number one, Kristen Gray. Welcome. Sway in the morning, Shade 4-5. Huh.
It's now or never.
You ain't gotta be freestyling it. It can be written, long as you spitting it.
All right. Set it off, time to speak the truth. Gonna speak the truth. Buckets of water when I leave the booth. Let my life be the living proof. They tough guys, but on the inside, they a chipped tooth.
Back at home before the show, we was stretching. Came for a game, homie, I don't need your lesson. Get the fact before you teach a lesson. And can he get 5 minutes before you test him? Meanwhile, God gave a promise. Done a lot for the city, I'm just paying homage. And that's for me, when they heard open door, they started asking, is he Christian anymore? I never was, it's Christian, bro. I follow Jesus, not the homies in them flowing rows. Keep my feet upon the rock when they throwing stones. Hope they all come together when they call us home. Share the land. This ain't easy, but we pushing through. 99 and a half, it just wouldn't do. The cross is over us, good dudes. Straighten up the crooked tooth. Now I'm going freestyle, cause like I said, meanwhile, I had a few chicks on speed dial. She wild, had a brother feeling kinda see now. It's Kristen, not Christian Gray, and I'm chilling on the show with Sway.
Hey.
Please don't change the channel. We tryna be a Uzi with no ammo. Back to the 90s. We gon' do it, we gon' switch, we rhyming. All cool, got Shabby in the background. We in the front, never show we back down. I'm just giving what I'm giving. Giving what I'm giving. Shout out to homie Jay Givens. Back in LA, streets of LA. Switch chalet.
Beat number 5, come on.
Now what y'all know about that? The homie stuck on the mumble rap. Don't know about that. Then I switch back my hat. I'm trying to show them what they don't know. I'm trying to switch from title and go to overflow. It's the Christian music streaming. I'm trying to do it when you don't believe me. This is all off the top of the head. I'm trying to do it like Sky Zoo said. Where I come, we stay fluid. On some Nike, homie, we just do it. We talking about placements. Lethal Weapon, I'm the new Damon Wayans. Got the white dude, whatever his name. And guess what? We ain't afraid to say his name. No shame, but no 116. I'll be good on Sway if I just do 116. And shout out to Lecrae. But every dog has his... With homie, but no shade. Already got 50 of those. It's all grave. Behave. Chill. Just stay saved. I mean, homie, really, where I'm gonna go? I'm just trying to go from show to show. I'm like 7 years married, and on some real, it's like the last 4 years was buried. 4 years was barely, and verily, verily shall I say, just keep it.
Yeah, that's all.
Right.
You good? You good? Off the top, for real. I just let you fling with it.
For those of you that think that gospel music
Sway the Morning,
Shade 4-5. Kristen Gray, Five Fingers of Death.
Praise Jesus.
I like that, man. Yeah. You keep going into that marriage, man. Marriage lasts
That's my life, man.
Yeah, last 4 years must be really hard, huh?
Yeah, it were. I mean, we got a 4-year-old daughter, Maya Blue, and I named her before I knew about, Jay and Beyonce. So I have to say
that's
that.
Cool. Did your marriage change after the birth of your daughter? Did that take a different swing on it, having a kid?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I think the thing with me is that I'm still discovering myself. We got married. I was young. I was very young. So a lot of life that I'm trying to learn, it happened while I'm gaining a platform in music. So all of that coming together, we all got our stuff. We all have our coping mechanisms, right? We're all trying to stay sane. And for artists like me, you're doing that in public.
Right.
So everybody gets to see it. Not only are they affected and you're focused on what you're giving to this world, because I'm so passionate about my message, you're also seeing how it affects the ones that you love the most.
Mm-hmm.
And, my wife, she's from Cleveland. She bang for real. So, she's been nothing but a good woman and a good wife. So to see me go through some of my ups and downs has been difficult for her as well. I just think we're at a crossroads.
Mm-hmm.
We're trying to see, what it's going to be. Like, you heard a very current verse. My first line on that Stop Me was, at the forefront of all of these people I front for, she might have found a reason to walk out the front door.
Oof.
So, I write very currently. Mm-hmm. It's not on some, 10 years ago we were struggling and now we all good and
present.
Nah, you hear it. And we'll document it. This is just a diary entry. We'll let God tell the rest of the story. We trust Jesus. I know his love is, it never fails, regardless of what the situation ends up being. Like, this is, he'll still get the glory.
Do you believe in divorce though?
Do I believe in divorce? It happens. You know, I think that if the relationship is extremely unhealthy, then you have to look at different ways to really consider all parties involved, especially when you have a child. Mm-hmm. So to answer your question, I've never looked at divorce as an option. I think that marriage is too precious of a gem to fight for. But I do understand that it happens. Mm-hmm. And for those, it's almost like I look at divorce the same way as I probably look at something like abortion, mm-hmm. where I don't recommend ever doing it, but there are people who have, and rather than hold something over top of them for the rest of their life, you have to be able to understand that human beings have human emotions and they have a cap of what they can handle. Mm-hmm. All I would say is just use these situations and difficult moments as opportunities to learn more about who God is and the love of Christ, because with him all things are possible.
Kristen Gray, that Glory album. Glory. I'm gonna take this one call and I'm gonna have you perform something for us, okay? So we're gonna have to clear out that corner. This is Daryl from Miami. Good morning, Daryl. How you doing?
Daryl, what's poppin'?
I'm doing excellent, Sway. I'm a citizen. I listen every day. I'm not really familiar with Christian Gray. I got to tell you, I got to be 100% honest.
You said my name right.
Oh, that's what's up, man. You're welcome, because I get that issue myself. But I'm also an MC, a solo MC, but I also have a cat that I rhyme with as well, kind of like a Redman, Method Man duo kind of thing.
So what's your question, Daryl?
Well, it's really just more of a compliment, Sway. It's more of like, you know what? I'm so glad to hear a brother walking in his purpose. I'm so glad to hear a brother not teetering. I'm so glad to hear a brother answering a question like direct and knowing exactly where it's coming from. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, it's so refreshing, man. I just thought about that. Every interview we do is like plucking teeth. Because a lot of, well, not every interview. Let me not say that. Not every interview.
A lot of people
are so calculated and guarded, they're scared to walk in their truth.
Truth, exactly.
So I appreciate Kristen Gray for coming up here walking in that truth.
Appreciate you listening. Yeah. It's not easy, but thank you.
Hey, Mike, get his album, the Glory album. Right now, I want to do something, man. I want to see if you could perform at least one song before you go.
Yeah.
All right, so what song will it be?
What you want to do?
Let's do the singing song. We heard you spit.
A record called Afraid With You.
Okay, Afraid With You. This is Kristen Gray. This is our Sway in the Morning concert series. We do it every Tuesday live on the air.
It's time.
Make some noise!
Bringing the concert to you. It's the Sway in the Morning concert series.
Your favorite artists performing live.
On Shade 45.
Now, this Glory album was released March of this year. The LP went on to claim the number 5 position on the Billboard R&B charts, while also hitting number 6 on the Christian chart.
Oh, wow.
And what makes this dude unique is, as well as he raps, he can blow a little bit too. I just say that. You know, I want to give him too much props, man. You know.
Pause.
I appreciate that. You got to keep that tough. You know, you're an Oakland fan.
Yeah, I'm an Oakland dude.
I appreciate that, man.
He's from Ohio, y'all. So I give him an 8.
We all in, man.
Okay, y'all right? You ready?
Is he still wounded?
We'll be back, right?
Okay, yeah, we'll be back. Afraid With You is the name of the song. It's on the album. Here's Kristen Gray.
I'm not afraid to watch you go, and I'm not afraid to watch you leave, but and I'm not afraid to say goodbye. I'm not afraid to set you free. Now it's 1 a.m, I'm trying to ignore it. The problem isn't gone away. I'm tired of fighting and I'm tired of writing. So hard to find the words to say. I'm not afraid of the games that we'll play. Afraid of us fading away. Through the ups and the downs we've been through. I'm so afraid of the way I love you. Can't explain what I don't know, and I can't explain what it's gonna be, Ba-da-da-da. With all this pain, I love you so. As long as it ends with you and me. Now it's 2 a.m, I'm trying to ignore it. The problem isn't gone away. I'm tired of fighting and I'm tired of writing. So hard to find the words to say. I'm not afraid of the games that we'll play. Afraid of us fading away. Not afraid that you'll always be true. But I'm afraid of the way I love you. I don't want to see you go. And I don't want to watch you leave. Ba-da-da-da. I'm giving up on all my pride. So I can give you all of me. It's 3 a.m, I'm trying to ignore it. The problem isn't gone away. But I keep on fighting and keep on writing till I find the words to say. I'm not afraid of the games that we'll play. Afraid of us fading away. Not afraid that you'll always be true. See, there's one thing better than being afraid with you. Only one thing better than being afraid with you. See, the thing that's better than being afraid with you is getting better.
Wow. Christian Gray, man, thank you for coming by this morning, bro.
It's my pleasure, man. Thank you for having me, all of y'all. This was on the bucket list, homie.
That's what's up, man. It's on my bucket list, too, to get you to do the Five Fingers of Death, but it happened, all right?
Thank you, bro.
Christian Gray, ladies and gentlemen, the Glory album. If you want to hear this back, you can go to SiriusXM.com/ondemand. And then tomorrow we'll be posting it on Sway's Universe. You can see it with your own eyes. You did the Five Fingers of Death. Great conversation.
Yeah.
Great project. At Christian Gray. Make sure you support him.
Damn, man.
Yep. Up next, we got Emmy Award winner, Golden Globe winner. The one and only Jeffrey Tambor is here to talk about season 3 of Transparent. You want to speak with Jeffrey, 888-742-3345.
It's Sway in the Morning, only on Shea 45.